Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to set up a fictitious virtual printer that will print PDFs if you don't already have a printer connected to your Mac. If you do have a printer already connected, like you have like an HP, you know, inkjet or something like that, you can already print a PDF, and I'll show you how to do that right now. If you're in an Adobe program, you'll just go to Print, Command P or Control P, and then you can come right down here to Setup, say Continue, and then go to PDF right here and Save as a PDF. Now, if for some reason that's not working for you, you will have to set up a virtual printer. If you're in the Adobe programs, you can usually just go to File, Save As, and then choose Adobe PDF right here, and it'll make a PDF fine. So this is really more for non-Adobe programs, or sometimes you might need this feature in Photoshop, like if you're wanting to add crops and bleeds to your document. Anyway, here's how to set up the virtual printer. First, you'll want to go to your System Preferences. So to do that, hit Command Spacebar and just type in System Preferences. Next, open your printers and scanners. Then, if you already have a printer set up, you should not have to do a virtual printer at all if you want to print a PDF, because you can use this printer to do that. If you don't have anything here, go ahead and click the plus button. Then choose this second option. And in your address, type 0.0.0.0. And for the protocol, you'll want AirPrint, which is at the top of the list. Under Use, click on Choose a Driver, and then select Software. And here we're just going to pick the HP LaserJet Series PCL4/5, and then say OK. Then click Add. Now when you do this, you'll get this warning that says, can't communicate with a printer, just go ahead and say Continue. And then say OK. And now your printer is set up, and you should see it right over here. So now let's try printing something. I'm here in Notes, and I'm just gonna hit Command P to print, and then right here you should see PDF, and we'll do Save as PDF. I'm gonna put this on the desktop, and then I'll save. And here's the PDF, and it looks like it worked. So that's all you have to do. Now you can save PDFs from pretty much any program on your machine. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little button next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.